Hello and welcome to today's discussion on free surface effect, trim and MCT of ships. This is a topic very important in ship stability subject, especially with regard to operation of vessels. We will have situations where the ship is supposed to have a trim, or ship will develop a trim due to some operational situations. Sometimes trim may not be desirable, we may have to remove the trim, or sometimes we need to generate a trim for some purpose, like the ship is in a rough sea and situations likewise. So in all these situations, we will have to move some mass on board the vessel in order to achieve the trim or remove the trim or control the trim. So the theory behind these things is what we will be discussing in today's discussion. Now we know that when any tank in a ship, whether it is a ballast tank, a fuel oil tank, lube oil tank, fresh water tank, if it has a free surface, if it has some empty space which is not filled in that tank, then that will have an effect on ship's stability. Technically, the height of the tank which is not filled is what we call ullage. If your tank has an ullage, it will have an effect on stability. So when a tank is completely filled with liquid, the liquid cannot move within the tank as the ship heels or trims. For this reason, as far as stability is concerned, the liquid may be considered a static weight, having its center of gravity at center of gravity of the liquid within the tank. Figure below shows a ship with DB tank which is filled with liquid having its center of gravity at G, small letter G. The effect when the ship is heeled to a small angle theta, the vessel has heeled to say starboard side to an angle theta, no weights have been moved within the ship, therefore the position of G, because there is no movement of mass, there is no redistribution of mass. So the position of G is not affected, it is the same. G remains G even after heeling. The center of buoyancy, however, will change to the low side indicated by BB1. Because the portion of underwater vessel, underwater hull has shifted. For this reason, we can see here this W1, this wedge L1, this wedge. So these two wedges have interchanged. Before heeling, if I call this point O, W1 was underwater, but after heeling, it has come above water, and an equivalent portion, which I can call as in a similar triangle, LOL1, which was previously above water, has come underwater. And for this reason, the center of buoyancy B will shift to a new point, B1. And we can calculate the moment. For any rotation, we require moment. So the moment required for this heel, we can calculate as W into GZ. From this triangle, we can find out that as W into GM sine theta. Now, consider the same ship floating at same draft, and it has same kg, but increase the depth of the tank so that the liquid now only partially fills in it. Then when the ship heels, as seen here, the liquid flows to a low side of the tank, such that now what has happened is the same situation. We have a tank which is having an ullage, an empty space. Now if the vessel heels, the mass of the liquid in the tank also shifts to the low side, and this will actually lead to a change in center of gravity of the ship, which did not happen in the previous case. So your G shifts to a new point G1 parallel to GG1. And in this case, the moment of statical stability is W into G1 Z1, which is nothing but GV into ZV. So we can get this as W into GV M sine theta. So now we can see both cases are different. When you have a anywhere on the ship, you have a tank with ullage. If the ship heels or lists, then we can see that there will be a change in center of gravity motion of the vessel, and as a result, there will be an effect on stability. You can see here, this is a new diagram. Previously, we did not have shift in G, but now G has shifted to G1, and you can see in the new case, the rightening arm G1Z is less than the previous rightening arm GZ. So as we know, rightening arm GZ is an indicator of stability, and for this reason, we can say that stability has reduced, unfortunately, because of the movement of water within the tank. So this demonstration shows you, this discussion shows you that if you have any tank in a ship with free surface, that will have an effect on stability. So as you know, when we have fuel oil tanks or freshwater tank, these are tanks which tend to become empty from a fully filled condition as the liquid in the tank is used up during the voyage. So at all points of time, there will be some tank in a ship with free surface effect, and when the ship heels or lists or trims or pitches, then unfortunately this liquid will also in the tank will move, and that will, as we have seen now, change the position of center of gravity, which will unfortunately reduce the stability of ships. So you can understand now that such a tank which is not completely filled is highly dangerous. So that is why, you know, all liquid carrying liquid cargo carrying ships like oil tankers, product tankers, chemical tankers, etc., they either have a fully filled tank or they have an empty tank. They don't have a situation where the tank is partially filled. It is highly dangerous. So this is something, as we have understood now, with respect to stability of ships. This indicates that the effect of free surface is to reduce effective metacentric height, GM to GVM. So if you have a free surface in any of the tank, it will actually lead to reduction of metacentric height. GGV is therefore the virtual loss of GM. See, this is very important. They are using the term virtual loss of GM due to the free surface. So if you have a free surface, it is as if your GM, the metacentric height, has reduced. So that is the indication. So this actually reduces the stability of ship. So this is very bad and something we don't want to have to occur in our ships during the voyage. So we can take mini steps like during the cargo plan, when we are planning to load the cargo or empty the cargo, we can keep this in mind that we should either have a fully filled cargo tank or a fully empty cargo tank. Otherwise, we can monitor like fuel oil tank, lube oil tanks, peak tanks. Peak tanks are another tanks which are partially filled all the times. So we can constantly monitor the level of liquid in these tanks, and we can calculate beforehand how bad in terms of effect on stability can happen because of this free surface, and we can accordingly take precautions and ensure that our ship is safe. Hope this discussion has helped you to understand how the free surface will affect stability. If you have any doubts or if you have any more queries on this, please feel free to